gonna see when, like, the Lord just gonna ride past him to get hit to the earth.
Like a camera ticket.
Yeah, the Lord them on their way. Come on, man. These devils
got some nerves. And these movies, they promoted. The brother seen the movie, which y'all just see this week.
Oh, Captain.
Yeah, Captain, you wanna speak on that?
No, they basically had the, basically how society would be with the chip. Like, they had, at first it was all chaos, Jacob's trouble, basically. Then after that, niggas was living life off the chip.
See that unicorn, that higher tech technology, they making news about that and stuff. Well,
it says, Isaiah 34:7, and all the unicorns shall come down with them, and the bullocks with the bulls, and their land shall be soaked with blood, and their dust made fat with fatness.
Right, and so this is talking about World War III. This is talking about the Lord, how he's going to obliterate America and everything that they stand for. He's going to obliterate the patriots. He's going to obliterate all you people that vote on it. All the parties, all you Edomites, all you all you elites that's on a whole nother level of prowess, he's gonna bring you down, man. And we just waiting on that, man. Like I said, we just like those goddamn hyenas that be waiting on that leopard to come down, man. Cause them hyenas will circle, will await your ass out, man.
That's right.
Until you come, y'all bring your ass down.
However long it takes.
However long it takes. The leopard up there, like, oh, hell no. But we waiting on your ass, basically. We waiting on the Lord to make his rules, bring you down, man. Cause I'm not positive to say, put up your ass, man. So keep going.
Isaiah.
Slavery. That's 1,000 years of slavery, man. Then after 1,000 years, Hey, that's it for you. It's it for you, man. Okay? 1,000 years of hardcore, cruel horror. Just straight horror, man. It's gonna be, every day gonna be a living fucking hell.
Is it gonna be the Lord 1,000 years?
Well, right, it's gonna be a long time, man. It's gonna seem like an eternity for them, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's gonna seem like, man, this gonna never end, man. One day gonna feel like, oh shit, man. That was one day. You know? It's gonna be straight.
Yeah, it's just like when you, start one of those, like start like a shitty job or whatever, or you know, it's your first day and you're catching all that element.
Yeah,
or you know, in your mind, you think it's like more than 100
hours.
That's only the first day.
You've been here all day catching hell, and then when you look at the clock, you've been there since 12, when you look at the clock and say, boy, you're like, damn, I've been only here for an hour?
That's how it's gonna be. And then we're gonna bless them with power. We're gonna be doing all types of stuff, bro.
Put you in depth, put your spirit back in you. Isaiah 34:8, for it is the day of the Lord's vengeance and the years of recompenses for controversy of Zion. The day of the Lord's vengeance, man. All right, the Lord is coming to stand up for who? Zion, man. That's a representation of the Israelites, man. So this is the day that the Lord's going to stand up for us 12 tribes of Israel, man, that's over here in captivity, and the Israelites that spread it throughout the four corners of the earth, man.
All right, this Isaiah chapter 63, verse 4. It says for the
red day of vengeance, right?
Yeah.
Okay, come.
This Isaiah 63:4, for the day of vengeance is in my heart, and the year of my redeem is come.
Right. So the Lord, that's all he think about right now. He's currently on his way. You know, the Lord is not just chilling in the heaven. The day of vengeance, he waiting for the Lord, his father, to station him.
He ain't done with this, bro. You know how they jumping? Hey, the Lord, like, hey, how was shot like this, man? Just waiting.
He's waiting, and he's ready, man. The Lord, he's waiting for the green light. Because once again, the Lord, our father, he's in command of everything. So everything work on his command.
And then we gonna know also, because the scriptures say that when the Lord tell Yahweh Shah something, Yahweh Shah let us know. So we gonna know when that time is here. We gonna know. Spirit.
Well, that's why the book of Joel speaks about brothers just start having a dream about, oh shit, so this is about to occur right now.
Right.
Brothers having visions, just like Moses. Moses had a vision. Right now, brothers get small visions and dreams.
But through the spirit, we're going to know. We're going to be like, okay, this is it. We know. This is it. We're going to
feel it in our spirit.
We're going to feel it.
15 minutes. Okay.
No, you good. I'm moving my arm. All
right, it says Isaiah 34:9, and the streams thereof shall be turned into pitch.
Yeah.
Thereof shall be turned into pitch, and the dust thereof into brimstone.
Yeah, and that goes to every essence of that. Once again, this not going to be just a, it's going to be no more imports of anything, man, all right? It's not going to be, and the streams going to turn to pitch. Everything going to turn into hell, man. Everything, the streams, it's not going to be just, so because right now, everything's a stream. Like, everything is moving, like, you know, trades is going on, networking is going on, someone can come, you can make money. Even war, like, hell, even soldiers go out to the Middle East sometimes and don't even shoot a gun. Now, they might work a deal with one of the motherfuckers, all right? So, but he said, look, this time, it's going to be straight dark. It's going to be a pitch. It's going to be straight chaos, man. That's what I'm saying. Even, you're going to know. The pastors always say, you're going to know when you're in Jacob's trouble, man. Right. You ain't got to ask. It's going to be trouble. Ask, right. Hell, even your average Edomite going to know, oh, it's turned up, man. And it's coming soon. And we're not talking hundreds of years. It's coming soon.
This Amos chapter 5 verse 18. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. To what end is it for you?
So the things that we've been reading, that is the day of the Lord. Alright, because you know, you got people out here that they say they waiting on the Lord to come, alright, and return. Alright, but like it's gonna be some peaceful day, man. Like it's gonna be a day of celebration. Alright, like it's gonna be a day of drinking and partying. The day of the Lord is not gonna be peaceful, y'all. Alright, Matthew 10:34 said the Lord is coming with a sword. Alright, go ahead.
The day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
Hey, the day of the Lord is going to be darkness and not light, man.
Right.
Alright, so hey, it's like, it's going to be a dark day, but it's going to be a state of confusion, man. You people not going to know what to do and what's going on, man. Go ahead.
As if a man did flee from a lion and a bear man.
Hey, that's like a snare, man. It's gonna be martial, it's gonna be a famine. Alright, you might escape the famine, the Lord might have it to where you get some food. Alright, but then you go around the corner, it's a wild beast right there waiting on you, man.
Yeah, like just like someone on it, like it's gonna be fighter jets, because America pride themselves on their Air Force. You're gonna get shot down and you're gonna eject. When you eject, you hit the ground, it's gonna be motion waiting on you, man. So it ain't gonna be no escape.
Went into the house.
Hold on, Slack, you see that one? So where the niggas at? What if the police go to a nigga one day? Where y'all niggas go protect them? Go see what's going on, man.
That's right.
Go see what the fuck going on. But they stop for us when we talk to the nigga woman. But when the police pull a nigga woman over, oh, you just gonna walk past like nothing going on? They screaming commotion over there.
Right.
Fucking see that goes to show you, man. It's a, you know, these niggas ain't worth ain't shit. They just want to have some camera views.
Or went into the house and laid his hand on the wall.
Yeah,
and a serpent.
And that's gonna happen, man. All right, you gonna have like I said, man. You might be on one street. All right, you might escape that street. Next street, you might be a martial law troop waiting on you, man. You might go into a concentration camp. The Lord might have it to where you get. See, the Lord gonna set you up, man. Hey, however you going out, whether it's a famine, pestilence, the sword, or even the missile. All right.
And the Lord is the ultimate chess player.
That's right.
Then I set you. I move my rook just to set you up with my queen or something. You know what I'm saying? Just to jump you with one of my pawns. You know, it's a setup game. You know, you escape one trap just to get caught up in the ultimate trap.
That's right.
It say, shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light, even very dark and no brightness.
Yeah, it gotta be dark, man. Cause why? You people ain't want the light when the light was here, man. All right, this is the light right here, man. The Lord trying to offer you the light. You ain't want it, man. So you gonna get that darkness, man.
That's right.
All
right.
Hey, guess what? I grew up
No. The verse is coming where we're gonna stop on that.
Isaiah 34:9, and the streams thereof shall be turned into pitch, and the dust thereof into brimstone, and the land thereof shall become a burning pitch. And that's talking about after the missiles hit this place, man. Uh-huh. All right, go ahead.
Jeremiah 50:40. As Yahweh overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah and the neighbor cities thereof.
Right, because it was five. It wasn't just Sodom and Gomorrah. It's five cities that was a part of Sodom and Gomorrah. That was two of the five.
It says, saith the Lord, so shall no man abide there, neither shall any son of man dwell therein.
I mean, this place is going to be completely obliterated, man. Nobody's going to dwell here no more. All the wickedness of America is going to get burnt up. And these people as well, man. They come with their own philosophies. They want to just come up here and cause confusion. It's a little irritating during the moment, but we ultimately know your faith. While we fighting for salvation, y'all basically just waiting for death.
Verse 10, I think that's the last part.
It's Isaiah 34:10, it shall not be quenched night nor day. The smoke thereof shall go up forever. From generation to generation it shall lie waste. None shall pass through it forever and ever.
That's one of my favorite scriptures. That's talking about that's it for America. And even in the kingdom, for a long time in the kingdom, we're going to still... America's still gonna have that smell to it, that smoke. We're gonna always, they're gonna be like a remembrance to us. They're gonna be like a remembrance, like, damn, that. We're gonna tell stories on how that happened, man. And America's gonna be a thing of the past. It shall no longer be a thing that we always remind us. Because soon, that just, like the apostle brought it down, that's gonna be just for a certain time. But soon they're gonna start smoking, and it's gonna be a desert land. It's gonna be a desert land, just for animals and wild beasts. But even with the first half of the kingdom, from the beginning, we're gonna have views of the kingdom. Lord, fuck that spot up.
It's gonna be what Sodom and Gomorrah was. The Lord said he left Sodom and Gomorrah an example of those who live
on God.
Even scientists, until this day, say, you can still smell the sulfur. I think we all seen that documentary. They said, this is still it's still heat to this motherfucker. You know,
it's gonna be an example of what happened when you fuck with the Israelites.
Just like you put out a grill, you got the barbecue, and you put a grill out, you can still, there's still a little steam to it.
Hey, go ahead. 1 Peter, the 4th chapter, I believe. What you just said, go ahead.
This, the 2nd Ezra 16:3.
Start at 1.
2 Ezra 16:1. Woe be unto thee, Babylon and Asia. Woe be unto thee, Egypt and Syria.
Hey, them all cold names for America. Alright, them all cold names for America. The scripture said woe be unto you. So woe be unto America. Alright, the death and destruction is coming to this place, man.
And I can say something real quick, because Asia is also, that's in the Middle East almost too. Because it's on that letter half, where they're going to be deaf all.
Russia,
all that, man. It's part of that landmass in the ancient land.
China.
Yeah, all that, man.
It say, gird up your...
Because Babylon, is one half of the hemisphere. That's talking about the second half of the hemisphere too. You know, that... That cutoff point, man.
Egypt, right there too.
Egypt,
that's right. And this place spiritually Egypt. Or Slovakia, wherever it's an Israelite at, that's Egypt.
Or because they ain't been some
bondage. Well, yeah, America represent all, because all these we've been in captivity in these lands, all right, before, and America just a representation of these other. Places, man.
Yeah, because guess what? You Edomites going to experience Egypt. In our kingdom, y'all going to experience a bondage. Right. Y'all going to a double straight. Y'all going to be in total fucked up.
But it say, gird up yourselves with clothes of sack and hair. Bewail your children and be sorry, for your destruction is at hand.
Your destruction is at hand, man. All right, the destruction is at hand. Which means it's coming, man.
Yeah.
All right, it's coming, man.
It ain't far off,
man. All right, it's not in the near. It's not when your grandkids have kids, man.
Kids.
It's gonna be. You gonna see this, man. You gonna see this movie, man. You gonna see this ending, man. All
right. And these prophets are gonna be thousands and thousands of years ago. And we finally in that time where the destruction about to take place.
Because this book is basically like a spiritual, like a GPS, man. All right, this is a book to follow, to lead you through this madness, man. All right.
And even so, even some, like, even so, you got things that correlated. It wasn't at its full scale back then. Even things that did happen, you know, people did get destroyed. But this at its full force. And then that don't come.
This is where you actually can see this. Oh yeah, that's going on now.
Right now.
Cause you know the prophets then they kind of couldn't really, you know, they didn't really understand. Yeah, right. But we living in the time now where we see these things coming to pass, man. Right. We living in the man, it's going down.
Right, go ahead. Right, and this is time everybody all the prophets been waiting for.